Hey, quiet. On air in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Morning.
And that's going any direction to 101 Sullivan.
Yeah, that's what happens, doesn't it?
B series bucket. There's a B bucket.
A B bucket?
Yeah. So, brand new. As the French would say, flambeau neuf.
Ooh.
So you remember some French.
Yeah.
What's it doing here? I just heard somebody ask.
Oh, yes. Good question. Yeah. Thank you for asking.
Well, first of all, this is from far, far away from here.
It is.
This is at least a 7-hour drive from here.
I mean, a 7-hour drive to bring it in so you could do the job for him.
Yep. So he wants a cutting edge put on it.
Yep.
He wants a spill guard. And he wants hooks. And he's a heavy equipment operator. And he said, I want the hooks put where you put the hooks.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he understood why I put the hooks
right
where I put the hooks.
Yeah, you understand the benefit in it.
So here's the situation. Fellas have asked me, and I know there's going to be a certain amount of new people watching this video. We have had an influx of subscribers. We've had at least 3 or 4 times as many thumbs up as we've ever gotten on any video.
That's right. So,
people listen during the last video.
Yep.
And that what that does is that creates encouragement. Somebody said, I don't understand what you need subscribers for and what you need thumbs up for. Well, the thumbs up basically is, it's like an approval rating. It's like somebody saying, oh, look what you did. I enjoyed the video. Here's a thumbs up.
That's right.
The subscribership, well, the more subscribers you have, the more attractive you become to advertisers.
Yeah.
And the more advertisers, advertisers that you have, the longer you can stay in the video business, because that's what supports the channel. Yes, AdSense brings in some income, but you know, we do get a certain amount of advertising money as well. And of course, the big benefit for us is it creates work.
Us, yep.
Yeah, we do. We get a tremendous lot of work based on our YouTube channel.
Oh, it's the best advertising out there.
There's no doubt about it. Because, you know, this guy came in this morning. We've never met him before, but he came in smiling, carrying on. He just knew us, right?
Yes.
And we had a great chat. So, yeah.
Yeah.
As Trump would say, this is a big lead. Anyway.
So don't steal his words, because he might see you.
Yeah, well, I'm assuming that might be copyright.
Exactly.
So here's what we're going to do. We're going to make up some plates. Don't know if we're going to show this all in detail because it really slows me down. But these are called weld-on chain hooks, okay? And the reason why they're called weld-on is you can see they're beveled. If you looked at them there, they're beveled on each side. Why are they beveled?
So you can weld up and down each
side of them? Yes, so when they're put on a plate, you can weld in here. They're already beveled. You just fill in that. And they're rated at, 6,600 pounds each. So that's pretty good. This here is what they call a D-ring, and this is rated at 11,000 pounds. So,
wow.
Yeah, so they're basically going to go in here, like I did pretty well on the BX. These are going to be placed in line, say, with the tractor arms, right?
Right.
And the one here is going to be put right in the middle on the inside. Now, this guy who owns this, he's pretty crafty. And he said, you put your hooks on the inside every time I see a tractor on the outside. And he said, I know why you did that. And I said, yeah, why? Because he said, you had a lot of experience with heavy equipment. I said, well, I do. And I said, well, give me the reason why you think I put them on the inside. He said, when you're pulling on something, like a nylon strap or even a cable, if it breaks, it becomes a projectile. A nylon sling or even a wire cable, when it snaps, it can actually look like an elastic band. And if it's over, if your hooks are on the back here, and you have your cable or your sling on the back, it can actually come back and flick over and strike you on the tractor. Or hit the windshield, or if it's an open station tractor, it can literally damage your tractor and injure you, or even worse, kill you. Now, I don't know, in some cases, probably better to kill you.
Yeah, I think so.
By putting the hooks on the inside, what you're doing is you're using your bucket as a shield. Okay? Mm-hmm. So when you're pulling, you pull your bucket up a little bit, and what happens is you always be prepared. If something snaps, your bucket goes up, and it's like putting your hands over your eyes. It's protecting you. Yeah. That's the reason why I put the hooks on the inside of the bucket. I have never in my life, when I was operating stuff like this, there would never be a hook on the outside of the bucket. The hook would always be on the inside of the bucket. And that was the reason for it. So I hope that clears up the bucket.
Right. The new viewers.
Yeah, well, even like, see, so many people, I don't understand why they put them on the outside. Now people say, yeah, but don't the dirt get caught up in the book and the hook and in the D-ring? So what? If you get a little bit of mess in there.
Yeah.
You push it off with your hand, you stick your chain on or your sling on, you go to it.
Yeah, it's better a bit of dirt and save life and limb.
Well, you know, it's just a matter of being safe, right? Now, the reason for the D-ring on the inside, these things aren't intended for slings, although you can put a sling on it. The D-ring, you can shackle it up, and then you can use your shackle with your eyelet in your sling, and you can come out with it. It's very versatile, right?
Oh, yeah.
So you got the best of both worlds, and it's going to be mounted inside, so you should be good to go. In this case here, we have the skid steer adapter, so we just might have to put the hooks over here a little bit to get clear of that adapter, because you can't put any holes through the adapter, because then the bucket won't fit on really good. So you can either go inside or go outside. So we're just going to choose to go just on the outside here, and still going to have a lot of protection and a lot of strength due to this piece of the attachment, right? The adapter. So that's it. That's going to be the opening. This is where we're going to go. So we're still gathering up a bit of material. You got to go pick up some, because we don't have anything that long here. We got the cutting edges there, and we have the top pipe, which we already had, which will be put on the top of the spill guard. So,
oh. Stepped on the slush.
Yeah. Scrunch.
Scrunch.
Yeah. So we'll come back shortly now when we get things organized and a few parts picked up, and maybe I'll show you little bits and pieces. We're going to try to stop doing the hour-long videos for a while. We'll go back to some shorter videos. A lot of guys like the only reason why I'm doing longer videos now in the tractor, because we're doing a commentary, we're talking a bit and whatnot. But
yeah, little snippets here and there would be good.
Well, exactly, right? I'm just showing the progress of how we're going. See, you can always tell that it's always one take, because I never... Like, I got a lazy tongue this morning. You'd never say it by listening to me. But I just can't get it to wag in the right direction, and the words don't come out right.
Ah.
Eh?
That happens.
Yeah, it's just not wagging properly.
Nope.
So we'll be back shortly. Yeah, I'm still at it.
Oh, yeah, getting it set up.
Yeah, there's a weld down here.
Oh, yeah?
And when you're placing your cutting edge, you got to try to keep it away from that weld if you can, because when you get into that weld, it's going to be very, very difficult to drill. Well, that's the reason why.
Yeah, it'd be pretty hard. Huh?
Yeah, it's well, you can ruin bits, and because that's a MIG weld. MIG welding wire is very difficult. The drill through. To be honest with you.
Yeah.
So we have 8 holes drilled. So I've avoided the welds, as you can see.
Yep.
I would like to get the mag drill on it if I could, but we shall come back after I figure out if we're going to use the mag drill. Can I get you to give me a hand to lift off that cutting edge? Hey, hey.
You've got a lot of holes to drill yet. How many altogether?
1,800. 8.
8.
Yeah, but you know, it takes a little while to set this up. But once you get it set up, this, folks, is a mag drill. Not a nag drill. If it was a nag drill, Kathy's mother would have the bit in her mouth. It's a mag drill. Not a nag drill.
Big difference.
Big difference. Much quieter than your mother, this is.
Oh.
Yeah. So now what we're going to do is I haven't used this a lot since I bought it. And it's probably only 10 or 15 years old. Don't ask me where I got it, folks. I'm going to tell you that I really don't remember.
No.
So the idea of it here is you got to keep it in place. You hit the magnet. And she stucks.
Mm-hmm. And it's the magnet.
It's a magnet, electric magnet. But you got to make sure. There's 2 things you got to make sure. You got to make sure you got it right. And nobody unplugs it on you.
Yeah.
Especially if you got it suspended upside down.
Yeah, that's right too. You did that one time, I think, when I saw you using it. It was on the side of a wall?
No, it was on, it was on the side. And on site, what you do is you, I went in and had to do some work on a crusher, mm-hmm. and I had to drill some overhead holes. So what I did is I inverted it, and I took a stud, you know, something like myself, and I welded it up to the inside of the crusher, and I suspended it, put a chain on it, and then I chained this on to the, so that way if the power ever went out, or if the generator or the welding machine ever cut out, this wouldn't fall down and beat itself up or kill somebody, right?
That's true, you need the backup.
So, this is a mag drill. It's electrically stuck to this now. This is only about a 3/16 plate here. These are way more effective. The thicker the plate, the more effective, because they got that more energy, more meat there to hold on to. But in this case, it's not so bad. We've already drilled one hole. It went pretty smooth. There's a little trick. These are called annular bits. These are made by Slugger. They're quite sharp. You really need to have cutting fluid on them at all times. Now, this arbor here has got allowances. It's got a little thing there where you can hook up an oil jug to it and the oil will come down through there. But for the amount of drilling I do, and it's not very thick, I don't need to hook that up. It's just a bottle that hooks up to it. So let's go ahead. We're going to get halfway through. Those annular bits, you can put a pilot shaft in them so you can get center hole. I don't have the pilot shaft in there. And those bits are hollow inside, so they're going to end up with a, you're going to go down, I would say 3/8 of an inch, and then the bit is going to get plugged up with this center hole. Then you take off the bit, you punch this out, and you finish the drill. Okay, so let's go ahead and give it a try. And we shall see what happens. You might want to make sure too that the speed of the drill bit is turning the bit slow, because you don't want to burn up the bit. See me throttling the levers here, because what I'm doing when I'm coming back on the lever, I'm making the cutting shorter
You're just kind of cutting them off as I'm going up and down. That way they're not coming up and wrapping around your arm and cutting yourself up, right? Show the good folks at home what it looks like down here. Look, see the little center piece, it stays there.
Oh yeah,
so we got to keep on drilling until that comes up, then we'll take the bit out, just knock it out and finish up that that particular thing. Stud off. So now we're going to take out the annular bit here, and we will have a look-see and show you what we have to do. Like, what I like about this particular tool, well, for one thing, there's not much work, not much physical work involved. And the other thing I like about it is it does a very nice tidy job. See, what happens is when that breaks off, it won't let it dip down any further. So you just basically take this and once back into the hole.
Yeah, it does.
So,
there it is.
Yeah. So now we'll put this back in place and we'll continue on as if we were normal, eh? So we'll, you can keep it, keep taping. Just as well to let them see one completely done.
Yes, and then we'll carry on.
And then we'll just carry on for the rest of it. So.
Yeah, so wait for lunch after that one?
Yeah, geez, dinner time. Yeah, well, that's what we'll do. Okay. Putting hardly any strain on this at all. This is like a walk in the park. But the beauty with these things is to make sure that you keep it well lubricated, and of course that goes with anything that you're drilling out in steel. The more lube you put on your more cutting fluid you use on your hole there, the better it is for you. And the bit looks absolutely new.
Good.
So, yeah.
That one through now?
That one's through, yeah. I'll show you in a second. I'm going to move the drill in a second. Will you wait? Wait, don't be so impatient.
So. Well, I can't help it. I'm just getting anxious to see it.
You're getting anxious now to go to dinner.
That too.
Yeah. So we turn off our maggot. Mm-hmm. We lay that down. And there you have it.
Think
of that. Have a look. Nice and clean. I've made them a little bit oversized.
Oh, yes. Oh boy, that is clean.
Hey, I'm telling you something right now. You always got to make sure you keep your hole clean. What are you laughing at?
Yeah, it's true.
What are you? Do you know what? You're a prevert.
What?
Because you had that evil look.
I did not.
You did.
You weren't even looking.
I was looking.
You weren't. You were looking down.
Yeah.
At your hole.
Well, this is life for me. I'm always in the hole.
Well, it's about to get worse because you got 6 more to go.
Oh yeah, 6 more to go. Yeah, so we'll go get our din din, and we'll come back and continue on.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll see how things look.
Yeah, from there.
Cool. Remember how earlier on I was telling you these mag drills don't work too good on thin metal?
Yeah.
Well, a little trick that you can do, if you're drilling for thin metal like this and you're afraid it's not going to have much magnetism on it, take a piece of plate, like so, and you can put it there like...
Oh my goodness, that's strong.
Oh, is it that strong? Now that's got twice as much the pulling power.
Wow.
Yeah, and remember I was taking the bit out to take that stud out, that little...
Yeah.
Yeah, well, what I've been doing here lately, in the last two of them, I've been knocking them out down here like this without taking them out, taking the drill bit out. So, yeah.
Figure things as you go.
Yeah, well, you know, it is what it is. Everybody's learning. There's nobody knew it all. Well, one person knew it all, and they crucified him. This is boring.
Oh, yeah, it's boring.
It's boring.
It's a lot boring.
Continue on. same thing here where you went through.
You get two.
Yeah, you get two out of it. Two for the price of one, eh? Two steps in. There you go. Yeah. Like I say, there's a little bottle that can hook up. Just move your camera down here. You see it here? See that there? So what you can do,
I'm sure folks at home, you can take this little bottle here, and you can hook this up to it here, right? And then you can hang it, well, here. Okay. Yeah, and you can fill it, but I mean, it's working quite well like it is. It's not a, it's got a little valve on the bottom too of the tank.
Okay.
Yeah. It's not a really, put it this way, it's not a Milwaukee magnetic drill, but I've had it for a long time.
Oh, yeah.
And it works very well. Now, just watch the plate come down. I'm gonna turn off the magnet. Watch.
Easy.
Yeah. That's amazing when you think of it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. It really, really is. So we're just kinda guesstimating where they gotta go. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. And then just continue on.
Sometimes it looks right, sometimes it don't look right. And the pressure's on, the camera's on. And then we'll take that and we'll put that.
Sweet.
Weird, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it makes life a little easier, eh?
Yeah, it sure does.
perfectly round.
Exactly.
Makes it better, because I mean, your bolts aren't going in diagonally or squished or...
Nope. Well, you know...
Slant, you know, you'd go in on a slant if you didn't get it perfectly smooth.
You can do it with a drill, with a regular drill, but I'm going to tell you it's
hard work.
It's hard work, yeah. There's no doubt about it. Cool.
Cool.
Good as new.
Yeah.
We shall soon be ready to try the cutting edge.
That's okay.
Soon be.
You got a mess made on the floor?
Yep.
A lot of cutting.
If you want to get the broom, you can... Come
up. Okay.
Get what you can, anyway. And I'm going to... I'll move the drill. But I got to get the... that bottom plate.
At least I have to get these out of the way.
Yeah. I'm going to use this 3-inch plate for the hooks.
Okay.
That'll be in the next video. We're going to do 3 videos on this bucket. That way we'll keep them all shorter.
Yeah.
We'll do the cutting edge, then we'll do the hooks, and then we'll do the spill guard.
Sounds good. Yeah, this better be simpler.
Yeah. I think so.
Yeah.
I forget how much this can lift, this magnet. I think it was around 1,200 pounds.
Wow.
Yeah. But now again, that depends on the thickness of the
metal.
Of the metal, yeah. Mm-hmm. The thicker the metal, the more hold it has. And another thing you should do too when you're using a mag drill is make sure you get all the cuttings off the bottom. That way when you hook the mag drill on, it don't have any high spots. Because mm-hmm. if it got any gap at all, you're going to lose that that force, right? May the force be with you.
That's a heavy unit, though.
Yep. Yep, yep, yep.
Don't trip up your cord. Drop that on my toesies.
you go knocking in down. Here. My gosh, it took off like a small cat. What are you doing?
My hole went in. Push her up here.
She can push that down there.
Squish.
Now. No, you're not done yet. Lock washer and a nut. Hurry on. You're not hurrying, huh?
You could have them all done, but don't I have one out? I have a feel for this.
Shock.
This is not good. Let go.
So I'm gonna come on your side now, man.
Oh, it's going reverse.
You can't go. I know, but I don't know which one. Something missing. Listen. 1, 2, 3, 4. My side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Guess what I'm doing here now?
Yeah,
well, I'm doing your side. Folks, this is what you get when you work with your wife. Constant harassment.
It's bad as that.
It's bad as that. No. And I don't know what it works here.
Gabbage.
Man, that lined up perfectly.
Gabbage.
Imagination, that.
Uh-huh. Imagine.
Grabbed the right socket. No.
What's the chances?
Yeah.
Want me to do that for you?
Yeah, want to? See? You're not long hauling
it. Well, when you do it, you just blast the wind out. And it's heavy.
Heavy, isn't it? Not saying nothing? What? Poor attitude for upper management. Very, very poor attitude. So she said, well, I gotta go to the post office. Step over there. What'd she come back with? Brand new pair of work boots. Any excuse to buy a pair of boots. Okay. Tips your name. Good about a pair of cuffs.
My cuffs are over here.
Show the folks at home. Give it a close up. What are you doing?
Oh, I was doing the man in white. You know, I'm not working.
Oh, yeah. Very good.
Price is Right.
Price is right. Oh, okay. Very good. Anyway, there it is. And they lined up perfectly. That's what it is to have the right tools and the right helper. I got to give you a compliment sometime, I suppose.
Yeah, I was going to say, you're definitely not talking about me. It must have been the mag drill, was it?
So that's it, eh, for this one?
Yeah, that's it.
So what we're going to do now is we're going to close up this video, folks, and we're going to put away our mag drill, and we're going to put away the tools that we have out now. Mm-hmm. We're going to clean up our floor, and then we're going to put this up on the two welding tables.
Cool.
Don't know how we're going to do that. Well, we'll have to connect it to 5740 and just come in without the bucket on. Mm. Without the... of course, I can lift it up with the ramp, sure, for that matter.
What about our hoisty table over
there? No, that's way over there, man.
Oh.
I'll put the hoisting under it, and we'll lift it up, and we'll put them on the welding tables, and then we're good to go, eh?
Well, while you're doing all of that cleanup, time to go on break from
break? He just got back from dinner.
I got something I got to do.
Oh, I'm sure you do. And none of it involves work. Anyway, so folks, hope you enjoyed that. That's how you put a cutting edge on a B model Kubota, or any bucket for that matter.
Yeah,
it don't have to be a Kubota.
It's just different size.
Yeah.
So.
And the way that the cutting edge is on it there now is that when this edge wears out, you take off those bolts and you can flip it over 180 degrees and use the back edge of it.
Yeah.
And there's some big advantages to a cutting edge on a bucket. And as I always tell people before in the past, is the cutting edge really adds to the bottom of the bucket. Don't wear out the cutting, the original part of the bucket. And also it gives the bucket some rigidity. It won't get that smiley face or that happy face. Mm-hmm. It gives it a lot of strength around the edge.
I'd say the cutting edge lasts a long time too.
A long, long time.
It's a hard steel.
Yeah, very long time. It's, I don't know how much scratching and pawing you'd have to do to wear it out, but it'd have to be an awful lot. Yeah. So folks, I think it's a well worthwhile project. Cutting edge Canadian is around 300,
yeah,
give or take. And bolts come with it. And so, just go to it if you want to go to it.
Yeah.
Hey, if you don't want to go to it, come to us.
That's right, if you don't want to go to it, come to us.
We'll see you in the next video, folks, which will be the hook installation, the hook making and the installation. Mm-hmm. You guys don't have to be buying fancy hooks off companies. You can make your own.
Yeah, that's right.
So, and we're going to show you how to do that. So we'll see you in the next video. You guys take care. God bless.